Hey everybody, my name is Miriam Smith and we're going to talk about Virginia Henderson's knee theory. I work at Catawba Valley Medical Center, which is an acute care setting, and we're going to discuss how to incorporate the nursing knee theory into acute care patients. The nursing knee theory was developed by Virginia Henderson to define the unique focus of nursing practice. The theory focuses on the importance of increasing the patient's independence to hasten their progress in the hospital. Henderson's theory emphasizes on the basic human needs and how nurses can assist in meeting those patients' needs. Virginia Henderson established major assumptions in her knee theory, which we're going to discuss. Nurses care for patients until they can care for themselves once again, and we're going to discuss how this can be achieved in patient care. Nurses are assigned patients each shift once they get to work each shift, and they care for those patients until they're able to be discharged or until they have a peaceful death. Each nurse attends to those patients' cares, each patient's needs. They feed them, they give them their medications, they bathe them, they follow physician's orders, and they tend to all those patients' needs each shift. Another assumption is that patients desire to return to health and then to be discharged home. And a way to achieve that is patients will often participate in their plan of care. Here at Catawba, we have patient care managers that visit patients every single day, and they help patients participate in their plan of care. The nurses will educate them on their discharge instructions, and also the patient care managers help. They facilitate the plan of care with the physicians. Patients often voice the actual desire to want to go home too. You know, when you're in the patient's rooms, a lot of them want to go home, so that's how that's also achieved. Another assumption that Henderson voiced is that nurses are willing to serve and will to devote themselves to the patient day and night. All hospitals are open 24/7, 365 days a year. You know, we work all holidays, Christmas, New Year's, Thanksgiving. Nurses work day shift, night shift, and nurses devote themselves to patients and their care and all of their needs. And being a nurse is a very selfless job. You know, you take care of patients, you know, giving of yourself. Henderson also believed that the mind and body are inseparable and are interrelated, is another assumption that she had. Henderson had major concepts which inside of her theory, and we're going to discuss those as well. A major topic is individual. Henderson stated that individuals have basic needs that are a component of health and require assistance to achieve health and independence or a peaceful death. She defined that patients are someone who needs nursing care but do not limit themselves to nursing or illness care. She believed that individuals achieve wholeness by maintaining physiological and emotional balance. Another concept is that the environment. The environment is made up of the setting in which an individual learns patterns for living. The environment also includes a patient's relationship to their family. Henderson explains that maintaining a supportive environment is conducive for health. Environment continued. She believed that society wants and expects nurses to serve of acting for individuals who are unable to function independently. Henderson's theory supports the tasks of the private and public sector or agencies in keeping people healthy. Another concept is health. Although health is not specifically defined in Henderson's theory, it is taken into meaning that balance of all realms of human health. It is equated with the independence or ability to perform activities without any aid in the 14 components of the basic human needs. And we're going to discuss further in this PowerPoint presentation Henderson's 14 components in her theory. Health continued is that nurses are key persons in promoting health, prevention of illness, and being able to cure patients. According to Henderson, a good health is a challenge because it is affected by numerous factors such as age, cultural background, emotional balance, and others. I know there's things going on in the world today of nurses promoting health and healthy living. And I know here at Catawba, there's many nurses who are trying to promote health. And, you know, that's our job as nurses, is to promote health, you know, as not only our own health, but as also is to promote health of our patients. So that's, you know, not only here at the hospital, but also, you know, as we're out in the community, is to promote the health of our patients and our families and, you know, anybody that we touch in our lives, is to promote the health of others. Another major concept of Henderson's nursing need theory is Henderson defined nursing as the unique function of the nurse is to help, is to assist the individual sick or well in the performance of those activities contributing to health or its recovery that he would perform unable, unaided, if he had the unnecessary strength or will of knowledge. The nurse is expected to carry out physician's therapeutic plan, but individualized care is the result of the nurse's creativity in planning care. You know, and I take that to believe that, you know, the nurses, we use creativity every day. You know, we get inventive when we take care of patients. You know, you have to, a lot of times you have to get creative when you're taking care of patients, you know, especially when you have those patients that have dementia or Alzheimer's, you know, to try to keep them safe, you have to be very creative in keeping them safe. The nurse should be an independent practitioner and be able to make independent judgment. You know, a lot of times when nurses are working at night, they have to, there's not always, you know, the physician's not always there. So the nurse has to be able to make independent judgment and take care of the patients until there's someone there. Nursing continued, the nurse has the responsibility to assess the needs of the patient, help him or her meet health needs, and provide an environment in which the patient can perform activity unaided. The nurse's goal is to make the patient complete, whole, or independent. And the nurse collaborates with the physician's therapeutic plan. And the nurse's responsibility is to help the patient to meet the goals, to be able to be discharged and be able to go home and take care of themselves independently. And that's the ultimate goal of the need theory, is for the patient to be discharged and be able to take care of themselves and be discharged. And then the last slide here is that Henderson explained that the role of the nurse is to get inside the patient's skin and supplement his strength, will, or knowledge according to his needs. When the patient is sick and ill, the patient's not able to take care of themselves, and it's the nurse's responsibility is to, you know, take care of that patient and, you know, be there for them and take care of them and tend to their needs until they're able to be able to go home and be that nurturing body for them. Continuing on here, we're going to discuss the 14 components of the need theory. The 14 components of the need theory show a holistic approach to nursing that covers the physiological, spiritual, and social needs. Continued, the Henderson called her definition of nursing her component, her concept, and emphasized the importance of increasing the patient's independence so that progress after hospitalization would not be delayed. She categorized nursing activities into 14 components based on human needs. The next slides that we're going to discuss and look at here is the 14 components of the human needs. And here illustrated, we're going to look at the 14 components, which is to breathe normally, eat and drink adequately, eliminate body waste, move and maintain desirable postures, sleep and rest, select suitable clothing and dress and undress, maintain body temperature within normal range by adjusting clothing and modifying environment, keep the body clean and well-groomed and protect the integument, avoid dangers in the environment and avoid injuring others, communicate with others in expressing emotions, needs, fears, or opinions, worship according to one's faith, work in such a way that there is a sense of accomplishment, play or participate in various forms of recreation, and lastly, learn, discover, or satisfy the curiosity that leads to normal development and health, and use the available health facilities. And those are her 14 components that are the major basis of her need theory. And these are designed to meet the patient's physiological, psychological, spiritual, sociological, and recreational needs. And this concept, although it was developed many years ago, it is still widely used within nursing practice today. And her concept, although it was relatively simple, it is logical, and it can be applied to patients of all ages and ethnicities and just about any patient that you come in contact. So it works well, especially within the type of patient population that I deal with in the acute care setting. It works really well with this type of patient population. And now to touch on the relevance to patients and how it can be incorporated into patient care, I chose to talk about how we can incorporate it into patient care. So you'd want to involve patients in spiritual activities, involve the patient in activities of daily living, encourage the patient to cough and deep breathe, and that would help to maintain their respiratory status, maintain the airway and pain management, including medications and relaxation techniques, ensure that they have a restful and peaceful environment to promote healing. Here at Catawba, we have the care channel, which we implemented back in the spring, which has 80 hours of naturescapes and peaceful music, and at night it illuminates the room with a stargazing, and it's been a wonderful thing for our patients. We have a lot of compliments on it. I love the channel. I wish I could play it in my office. And then moving on here, you can encourage the use of cognitive behavioral relaxation, including music therapy and guided imagery. And one thing we have here at Catawba is that we have pet therapy a couple times a month. We have volunteers that bring in dogs that come through and visit the patients. A lot of patients really enjoy that. Use empathetic communication, encourage patients and family communication, promote a safe environment for the patient. Here at Catawba, we have a strong, safe environment. We work with fall safety, fall prevention, and then keep the patient warm and provide heat or air conditioning as appropriate. And then Henderson's knee therapy can be applied to the nursing practice as a way for nurses to set goals for Henderson's 14 components. Meeting the goal to achieve the 14 needs of the patient can be a great basis to further improve one's performance towards nursing care. In nursing research, each of the 14 fundamental concepts can serve as a basis for research, although the statements are not written as testable terms. And then Henderson believed that nurses should be educated at the university level in both arts and sciences. And then using nursing theory, including Henderson's knee theory, in clinical practice helps students and nurses develop analytical skills, critical thinking ability, to clarify their value and assumptions when caring for patients. And then relevance to overall healthcare. Virginia Henderson's knee theory is simple and easily applied to any type of patient care. As I said, you know, here in the clinical and acute care setting, it's easy to apply her components and her 14 components to our type of population. Her knee theory continues to be widely used in any type of setting, even today. And then her theory is beneficial to patients because it offers a holistic approach to her care, which all of us know the holistic approach is very important to patients these days. I really enjoyed learning about Virginia Henderson's knee theory. I personally would have you know, thought about her knee theory and have tried to really incorporate her theory into my own personal care, although I don't work at the bedside every single day. I still work at the bedside some. So this class has really opened my eyes, and I have really tried to work hard to incorporate her theory. So I appreciate you listening to my presentation, and I hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks.